This way I can see you guys. I think we're conditioned to fail. What do I mean by that, conditioned to fail? We hear, like today, we hear all these success stories. We go to seminars and real estate clubs. We read books. We watch YouTube videos. And we hear all these success stories. Does anyone ever hear, anybody here ever hear of the scientist Ivan Pavlov? And he discussed conditioning. And the thing about it is, if we go out there and we listen to the guru and they say, make 100 phone calls a day and read this script. And the result is we're exhausted. We've had a lot of rejection. We've got a lot of, we didn't make any money, the greatest sin of all. How does that make us feel when somebody tells us, this is the greatest way to do this. Just do this, buy this application, do this, do that. Send out these emails, send out these letters. And we do exactly what they say and it doesn't work for them. It doesn't work for us. How does that make us feel? Not very good, does it? Yeah, down. It doesn't make us feel good at all. We need to be conditioned to succeed. It is so important for us. You heard people today talk about speaking with other people. We need to be reinforced every day with success stories, even if we don't make a sale, but we have those good adult to adult conversations. We speak to people, nice, they're nice people out there, believe me. They have problems, they have needs, and you become the doctor, and you ask these questions, not as a salesperson who's trying to manipulate them. You say, what's your greatest challenge? What's your biggest problem? Why are you trying to sell this home? Why don't you keep it? Why do you want to buy and invest in my property? Why do you want to do this or that? And you keep asking those questions and you have that nice dialogue. And they'll give you, if you ask the right questions the right way, they'll give you what you want. But even if you don't close them, how will that make you feel at the end of the day? If say you had 4, 5, 6 conversations during the day, and they were good conversations. Maybe you got a follow up. Maybe like Chris said, you'll 2.5 years later, that's really stretching it. But if you have good conversations all day versus getting the rejection, the hangups, why are you bothering me? Take me off your list. I don't know who you are. Leave me alone. How does that make you feel when you're getting more positive conversations with people interested in your product or service? Makes you feel good, doesn't it? Even if this, sale is, even if it's the sale is there. Go ahead, Stephen.
Yeah. Well, which one? Okay. It's more of what they call a compound effect. You know, you build up your confidence. You might not make the sale, but you're going to get better. You're going to get better. You're going to get better. It is once you get someone really good on the phone, it's like, man, I've got the confidence. I can close this person. So you're building up your confidence, compounding it every day. The more you do that every day, the more expensive. It's like, okay, great. See what's going to happen in 2 or 3 months. You don't know, but you're going to keep building up your confidence. So that's all it is. I like it. When you have that conversation, you know it and you're getting better.
You're getting better. And did anybody ever